is pretty awesome. Well, they're terrified. What's this happening? That looks pretty bad. What the hell is this? It's a person with tentacles. Abaddon's abyss. We're done for. What is it? Well, that's the sorrow itself. Great. Alright, we gotta help as many as we can. And then try to get the hell out of here.
Why not?
This takes so long to run through everything.
Happy to help.
Well, this extinguishes the fire. Here comes Andronis. To see them working together and not arguing. Can I activate this one? Out of range? Yeah, it's out of range. Where am I? I'm all the way over here. I'll go as far as I can, which is like here.
Yes.
I'm glad you agree. Calistes, can you activate this?
It is done.
It is done. Nowhere is safe. Get out of my way. Thank you. I mean, you're welcome. Oh, good God. That is one scary freaking thing. I'm afraid they're done for. These people. What? That was like 400 something points. Good God's about. It's here. It'll kill us all. I'm not sitting around waiting for you all to snap out of your terror. Well, it's good for yourself. Okay, looks like we're not getting out that way. Adira shouts to you above the din. Hope is not lost. The Feratory. If there is any truth in the legends, then it is our only hope. She looks up at the towering sorrow, but you'll need time to understand it. If one of us is brave, perhaps others can live to find a way to stop it. She breathes in, once. I am brave. I am brave. I will buy the time for you and the others, young one. Make the most of it. No, Adiris, we need you. She turns away, hearing your words but ignoring them. Indigo Tide raised a small amount. A golden glow surrounds her as she steps forward, a kaleidoscope of beautiful colors, the shifting energies of the tides cast into tangible being. She holds her hand aloft, and ethereal fires play around it. The weight of the sorrow's baleful eyes focus. The weight of the sorrow's baleful focus settles on her. Your vision shrinks to a pinpoint as the two face each other. Oh no. Attend me, sorrow. She's doomed. We need to free that guy. That didn't do much. And she's God's attention. Save who you can, and you run. Well, there's nothing to do in all of here. We activate this field. No, of course, because I can only move tiny amounts. Oh, that's right. I'm all the way over there. How far can I move? Too close to this damn thing, that's for sure. We need to activate this to help that guy. Oh my, there's a sorrow thingy. Aratus? Aratus can activate this.
Why, of course.
It's like they're answering me. Can you guys interact with that? That'd be awesome. Okay. And so we're done with all this. I need to make my way as far as I can.
I'm going.
Nowhere is safe. Yeah, especially not there. Yeah, run, dude. Calistige.
Allow me.
Go on. It's a good girl. Uh-oh. Where's our sire? Does he even care that this is happening? Nah. If he does, not enough. Well, you're moving too far. I don't want you all the way over there. Holy crap. Focus on me! Now, what is this over here? There's loot? Screw the loot. Interact with... with what? I'm guessing not the sorrow, but whatever's behind it. And where is he? He's right here. What if I interact with this?
Absolutely.
Smash the smaller rocks to free the boulders. Probably also be fighting these things. Where's Aratus? All the way up here.
Want a job done right.
Have him remove this. If we free it, at least... ah. Requires an action, damn it. Oh, he's gonna do it. Nice. Good work. Awesome. Now, there's no one stuck back here. I don't see any reason to even mess with this. With these rocks. We need to make our way to this thing. We know it'll probably kill us. I thought this was that, so we never activated that. But, that's alright. So who is it? It's my turn. I'll help Melmoth if I activate this thing. Nothing can be done now. Don't waste your time. Go off and be someone else's hero. I'm trying to help you. Any opting? Okay, we need to go activate this next. Requires action. These guys will probably do it. I've lived too long to die here. I'm afraid you're doomed. Who's that? Oh, Adiris. Well, he's leaving us, or all these guys. That's a lot of friggin' points. Is she gone? Tiber's turn. Can't go that far.
Why not?
So weird. These guys are standing in the way now. Is he stuck behind this? I'll break this neck, see if he can get free, even though he told us not to.
I am the very soul of action.
Yeah, the very soul of action, but he can't actually do anything. Oh, they're in the way. Well, actually, you can get past them.
Yes, now.
Did that work? Alright, well, maybe he can get free now. I don't know. She's not very strong. But it worked. But we're all gonna die, man. She did both? What about these guys hang over there? They're not even moving. You guys better go. Get out of my way! Now they're moving. Good, good. Flee to safety, or you will all be killed anyway by this frickin' territory. I mean, I was killed. How are they gonna live? They're gonna fight it? What are they doing? Oh crap, gone. Yeah, we have to just get out of here. Because these things, like... This sorrow takes like 100,000 points or something. I'm like all the way over here. Crap. How far can he go? Glad they get the far away as you can from this freely. Okay, it's attacking me. Gotta get out of here. I'm just gonna have him... I don't want everyone to leave yet. Maybe we need to activate this thing first. Here's Andronus. Rima. I guess Melmoth's not gonna leave. I need to get far away.
Let's go.
Come on, guy. Oh, I can talk to him? Crap. I wonder if I can convince him to help. I didn't realize I can talk to him. I'm gonna have her, hide. I don't think there's time to talk to him. Crap. Going in?
I feel terrible.
Yeah, it's not a good thing. I don't think he can be helped. He's not without me. Sacrificing myself. Oh crap. I have to leave Melmoth.
Can't die.
I died. Your hunters at last hounded you down and put an end to the pursuit that began before you even awoke. For you, all is over, but for your foe, there is merely a new quarry to be slain. Okay, I'm gonna lower my save and do this again. This time I know better what to do, but I'm gonna skip all this for you guys, or most of it. Okay, so Eritus. I'm gonna try to talk to Melmoth. Melmoth gnaws at his lower lip. Blood trickles from his lacerated flesh, but he doesn't seem to recognize the pain. He stares blankly at the destruction around him, his eyes flat and distant. He gazes at you momentarily. It seems he hardly recognizes your presence. "It's here," he whispers. "So this is our doom. All of our lives have been leading to this moment. We cannot escape that." He gestures you away, not looking at you. "Run if you like. I accept our fate." Let's try intimidation now that we have a rank in that, right? Challenge his defeatist attitude. Oh wow, probably gonna lose this one. Nope. Can't get that high with Eritus. Melmoth glances at you briefly, then turns back to the flames. "If I fled now, would not the sorrow find me someday anyway? My life has been a futile pursuit of memory. All is dust and ashes, meaningless. We vanish in the fires of time, our history strewn into the uncaring sky. I will not leave." Damn it. Right, so this time I picked up this loot. 68 shins, a kaleidoscopic mirror caster. Is this the one we used to go into what's his name's mirror and find Mazoff? "This small, heavy tube seems heavier than its materials of amethyst, glass, and bronze would suggest. Its metal is etched with indecipherable symbols, and when you stare through it, it's as if through a spyglass. The shapes you see lurk just beyond your comprehension. It is tempting to linger and gaze longer at these unhappy forms." I think that's the same one. I'm not completely sure, though. I mean, I'm not going to use it now in any case. And we have liquid death? That was a joke I had when I was in, when I was younger, in the 90s. I used to say liquid death in the form of a liquid. And I would actually take cans of Coke and make my own little labels and put liquid death on them. "This small clear tube holds a tar-like liquid of deepest onyx. When you turn the tube over, the liquid undulates slowly, as if carefully considered whether to move, then made a conscious decision to slither in the direction of gravity. It waves over itself, through itself, and each time your surroundings seem darker. Oh my. Well, we'll take him. Okay, now I'm having Aratus remove this stuff. Avoiding the sputtering energy, you remove several heavy stones from the pile. The exposed synth tubes flash as some of the heavier rocks fall onto them and disintegrate with a hiss. The remaining rubble rests precariously on a single round hunk of stone. Okay, so we actually need another turn doing this. Cleared of smaller debris, you can see that the boulders blocking your path lie gingerly in a broken column. A formerly buried conduit crackles with energy below the stones, so you can throw your weight against the rocks or try to lever the rocks free. Smashing, I think, would work better for Aratus. You set your hips, twist, and hurl yourself forward shoulder first. The stone thuds against your weight. A moment passes before the pile slips and collapses. The mound crashes into the synth lattice and atomizes. The last of the rocks buries the device. Okay, so now we can actually pass through there, which is good. I don't suppose we can activate this. He's very helpful right now. Okay, they're leaving it. Okay. Just leave it. Can I activate this?
I'm ready.
To help this guy? Keep going. Ouch. Okay, can Calistige talk to Elkishai? I don't think we need to break this, we can just walk around it, right? Where is he again? Elkishai. He stands frozen, doubled over. His hands are smashed against the sides of his head. I can't. They're screaming at me. I can't. Slap some sense into him? Or convince him to get a hold of himself? She can't really do either, she just has speed. Yeah, this is no good. Crap. I can't. Okay, we need to have someone else do that. And we need to leave. She's dead, like 4 million points or whatever. Why are we moving all the way over there? I wish Tybear was all the way over there. You can run all the way up here. Aratus can do this. Oh crap. Nope, not yet. We're doomed for this friggin' thing. It's gonna go after us next. Who's this? Wait, who is that? Oh, Elkishai again. Yeah. It's my turn? Oh, crap. I don't have time for this. I can't help him.
In this world, then.
Oh, she can't do it. Yeah, she can't do it. She has no strength. We need to get the hell out of here now. Doomed. There's the last cast off. You're gonna attack me now. Damn it. Okay, since again Eretus got to him first, I think it was the same time last time as well. Gonna try the smashing melee weapons to try to slap some sense into him, because intimidation isn't really gonna work. Not with Eretus. This Alkashai, by the way. He reels from the blow, clapping his hand to his bruised cheek. A measure of sense returns to his eyes. Thank you, he says, swallowing. How can I help? Tell me what to do. Ask him to help save other cast-offs. He nods reluctantly, biting his lip. Okay, so how helpfully he'll help out. So now we need to try to help Melmoth and make our way to the exit. I do have might. I can't do that. I was gonna have Calisthenes do it, but let's see. She probably can't even do it. Yeah, step away. Damn it.
In an instant.
50%. Damn, we're wasting time. Pile does not budge. So, can we have her do something else? Do this? And we don't need to break this. He can just walk out this way, right? I'm not even going to fight them. Alkashai is going to help other cast-offs somehow. He's probably going to die.
ways.
Okay, we're getting him to come with us. Success. Melmoth tears his eyes away from the flames to stare at you. He coughs a bitter laugh. Hope is the folly of youth, but if I die here, all my life's work is for nothing. Might as well try. Is that what you're saying? See if I can scratch out a few more years? Or at least make sure someone else can scratch out a few more of their own. Fine, let's go. Okay, now we need to heal. Now we need to just leave. Alkashai, you better go get away from that thing. You're doomed. Attack him next, and then yeah, give us some time. Nah, I guess not. We still need to break through this thing and then leave. No, stay over there in the flames. Focus on me, Adira says. Yeah, we need to start making tracks. Please let him break at this turn, too. Damn it. Can we go around it? Maybe it's easier to just go around it. You want to break it? Fine. Thank you. Trouble here. Okay, Melmoth's leaving. Yay! Okay, we need to get as far as we can. Which isn't far enough. Still gotta get Calistes up there. She can go farther. How far can she go?
As you wish.
She can't break it, but I can move her there and move her around it. I'm not sure Alkashai is going to make it out of there. She's dead, let's get out of here. It's very sad, I know. Whose turn? Tybeer? can go right up to it but not interact. Or should he just break this? No, we need to move him. The thing's gonna come for us next. Sorrow. Even as the heat of the fire cracks and blisters skin, the air around his structure feels damp and pregnant. It pulses in a way it wasn't before, some kind of reaction to the sorrow's presence. As it is approached, three bone-like handles curl out of the structure as if in greeting. That certainly didn't happen before. A telepathic whispering begins, a cold, cacophonous chittering that is clear despite the roaring flames all around. Something is alive inside this thing. Turn the nearest bone. The lever rotates slowly across the face of the structure, lubricated by a mucus film. It locks into place and withdraws into the pyramid. The cacophonous chittering grows louder. Two bones still protrude from the structure. Here's where we're doomed. This is blocking people. Oh, he broke it. Good. You guys turn the other bone things? I'd appreciate that. Please let me go all the way over here. Damn it. Can't move far enough, damn it. Calistige?
We shall see.
Turn that bone. Turn that bone. Two cartilaginous joints remain extended from the base of the structure. The cacophonous chittering has grown even louder. Turn another lever. A few seconds of pulsing ratchets the joint into place. It slides soundlessly into the pyramid. The psychic noise grows even more painful, more eager. Only one lever remains unturned, or lever. Someone else turn this thing? I mean, just feel free, you know. Okashai! Oh my god. Hoping it just attacks Elkashai or this other guy first. But at least we're gonna make it, right? Have to sacrifice these guys for the others. Can't save everyone. I'm not sure if it's possible. Be cool if it was. Tiber, where are you, guy? You gonna turn that other one? Scared me, make me think he was over there. A single femur protrudes from one side of the pyramid. The voices have grown to a painful pitch. Whatever's inside is eager for the structure to be open. Not sure I like the sound of that. Turn the last joint. As the bone glides into place, a gurgling screech rakes the sky. The cacophony of voices lashes out, seeking a mind to latch onto. It's seeking you, the last cast-off. While I'm here... So Tybeer, is there anything else he can do? Probably not. Unfortunately, I still have to work my way over to the thing. And Jonas. Sorry, Jonas, it wants me. I can have your own way. Okay, me. Good. I'm closer to it than I remembered. As you approach, a voice, or a thousand voices, moan in your head, forming a connection with your mind. One side of the pyramid swings open, a swirl of trans-dimensional energy and biological fluids blasting inside. Ugh, a portal with something else waiting on the other side. You can only hope it's not worse than the sorrow that hunts you here. Are we all getting out? Did I save all these people? Hope so. The interior of the pyramid swirls with a mysterious energy. A loud, plaintive chittering beckons. Please just suck everyone in. I don't want to have everyone go again because we might not last another round. Before you can react, a powerful gravitic force yanks you and your companions into the structure, away from the horrors of Miel Avest. It wrenches the other surviving castoffs inside as well, hurling them to other places beyond your reach, and you suddenly find yourself somewhere else. Well, thank God. I'm pretty happy about that. Somewhere else is a good thing.